What's up, YouTube? Zamas555 here. 1 second to fix the lighting because it's kind of weird. I'll be like Tabuscus. What's your redness than darkness than whiteness than blackness or something? I don't even know how he goes. Redness than black, something like that. Anyways, yeah, I'm just organizing cards. I did some testing for the new format last night. And the game is significantly slower, and I kind of like it, actually. I think it's really cool. There's a lot less sack involved, which is obviously pretty stellar. Water is still, in my opinion, the best deck in the game. Konami made, I think personally, a slight mistake of putting D-Fisher, Soul Drain, and Macrocosmos 2-1. I think D-Fisher and Macro could definitely be hit, but I think Soul Drain should stay at 3. Okay, here's my question, Konami. Why is Soul Drain at 1, but Skill Drain is at 3? I don't really understand that. Why I don't understand that is because I personally think Skill Drain is a way more broken card, because it just shuts down like everything. So I don't know. I think we're going to be seeing a lot of stun decks this format, unfortunately, because, you know, Heavy Storm's gone, so you can pretty much just, like, set 5 now and then summon, like, TG Warwolf or something, and you're like, look, I got 3 Horn of the Phantom Beasts set. I didn't like Horn of the Phantom Beasts before, but when I get my Fire Kings all finished, I will be running triple Horn of the Phantom Beasts in that, because that card is insane. It gets over Ophion, unless they Safe Zone it, which Safe Zone is also going to be another really amazing card in this format. So anyways, what am I doing right now? I'm basically just, like, you know, fixing my decks up for the new format. I was testing Psychics for next format, and they weren't bad. Like, I was playing Brendan's Water, and Water is so retarded still. But and I won. He never really 2-0'd me. I won at least one game out of each match, which was cool. It was honestly just the fact that his deck's still way too fast. And sadly, Psychics can draw in consistent hands. I only have 2 Scapegoats as well. I really wish I had a second one. Because every game I drew Scapegoats and, like, Witch, I won. Because you just go, like, set Witch, set Goat, and you're like, come at me, bro. And he's usually going to, like, do the Marksman, pop one or the other, and you're like, okay, pluses. And then the Witch is going to bring out another Witch, or you can bring out, say, Esper Girl and start making Synchro plays. And it was actually really, really good. I was really enjoying it. But like I said, it's a bit too slow. I do love Psychics, but I'm just not sure about the deck, in all honesty, and it does really lose to Yule Swarm, so I might, I'm probably going to take Psychics apart, and I'm honestly thinking, like, Herald's going to go back together, because 3 Earth is pretty sexy, to be completely honest. Like, come on, guys, 3 Earth is pretty gross. You know, even if I had Strikers, I don't think I do have Strikers, but even TG Agents would be freaking awesome. Like, that deck is back, too. You can run BLS and stuff, which is really cool. Yeah, Chaos Dragons are still good too. I mean, I was testing Chaos Dragons and I did like them a lot, but, you know, only 1 Sork still and 1 Gorz, and now Avarice is gone, is honestly a little scary. And why is it scary? Because it's one of those situations where, you know, if you mill the Chaos Sorcerer or the BLS before, you'd be like, oh, no worries, I still got Avarice left. And you're like, oh, look, I drew Avarice. You're like, put them all back in the deck and you're okay. Now, if you mill any of your big monsters that you want to, you know, banish stuff to special, you're like, I'm going to lose. So mill decks aren't as good, in my opinion. That's what I say. Personally, I think that the Numero Uno mill deck is going to be Lightsworn. Why do I say it's going to be Lightsworn? Because they have Beckoning Light. So if I mill any of my good stuff, I still got Beckoning Light. I mean, I can just, like, set it. You know, it's a little sketchy because more people are going to be setting MST and stuff now, I think, because they're not going to be as worried about it getting stormed. It's not gonna, like, I noticed last night when I was testing, the game is so weird now. Like, it's just, I was doing weird things I'm used to doing. Like, I was like, okay, I got 3 back rows in my hand, I should probably just set 1. Or I got 3 back rows in my hand, I should probably just set 2. And then I'm like, wait a minute, what am I doing? I can just set all 3. Like, what the frick am I smoking? It was funny situations like that, and it was like, I think everybody's generally going to have to change the way they kind of play. So it's definitely going to be interesting. I was playing Insectors. They are so good still next format, really. Like, Brendan was beating me with his Water, but he was I was getting a little confused. He was literally drawing Dragoons every freaking game, and it was getting a little suspicious. I don't think he cheats, but sometimes I wonder how people shuffle, so Yeah, anyways. The deck was testing really well. I was testing some weird stuff, though. I was testing two pinpoint guards. This card's going to go up in price a lot. Make sure to pick them up, and they're cheap. They're about $10 now, but they're probably going to go up even more. I think they're completely sold out in Toronto. This is just a really amazing card. I actually won one game against him because he went to OTK me, and I had the one back row set because he ended up marksmaning and popping the other back row. I was like, oh, shoot. And I still had this, so I was safe. And I ended up maxing before, and I didn't draw into Gores or anything because Gores is obviously still at 1, which I think it should have gone to 2 still. But and then I ended up playing the pinpoint guard and bringing back the maxi in defense position, and he couldn't get over it. And the next turn, I'm just like, Dragonfly Hornet! And I, like, killed him, so that was kind of funny. But, I mean, I don't know. Like, there's going to be a lot of, you know, this is my stack. This isn't too bad. This is my stack. I'm sure some people is worse, but, like, these are all my banned holo cards I have. There goes Gateway. There goes my Superstorm. There goes my other Gateway. There goes my nice LOB. I think it's LOB, isn't it? Yeah, LOB Monster Reborns are gone. There's my other Storm. It's my lovely Avarice. There's my other Storm. There's my other Reborn. There's my other Trunade. I just threw that in there. Shockmaster, no! It's okay, you put in work. The other Avarice, another Reborn, and we're back to the start. So, I mean, that's not as bad as some people's piles. I'm sure some people have some massive piles of cards that got hit. They're like, I just lost so much money. Generally, everybody who bought Trishulas is probably killing themselves right now. Or they're already dead. So, decks I think are going to be really good for the format. As you guys can see from the title, I'm going to be testing on DN. If you guys want to play the new format with me, it will be in, it's like unrated, unlimited or something. I forget what it's called in the end, but anyways, if you guys want to play against me, by all means, throw together a deck. I'm interested to see what people are going to be playing for the new format. The only ones I have really, like, I know how I'm going to be playing them, because I think I got a build I really like, is Inzectors, and I love my Constellar build. I wish I had two more Lances. I should have picked up the Commons and the Starfoils where they're cheap because they've gone back up in price. So instead I'm going to be running two MSTs and a Lance. I think that would be just fine, to be honest, because I do have Safe Zone and stuff as well. But Constellars are going to be really, really good. I mean, they didn't really, like, my back rows in Constellars before was I ran, like, triple Fiendish Chain, right? The two Vanities Emptiness, the two Safe Zones. And then I ran two Bottomless, Compulsory, Warning, and Judgment. So what I actually ended up doing was I just replaced the Judgment and one Bottomless for two Mirror Forces. I really didn't lose anything. Like, Constellars are still really good. And in the spell lineup, you know, I ran Storm and I ran Reborn, but I ended up just dropping those for two Dualities, just to add a little more consistency. And I dropped the one Tanky for another Sheraton. It's a little bit slower, but I mean, the format's slower. So, I mean, you can get away with just going, like, summon Sheraton, set four back row, have fun, bro, and you can still do really well. So, but anyways, yeah, if anyone wants to play, I'm going to hop on DN. And, yeah, we're going to see how things roll here. Let me just get the screen sharing up here. Yeah, I'll be really interested to see what decks are going to be in the format. I think Blackwings are going to be good. I really do. Because they do have that, you know, very, very overpowered card called Kalut. And Kalut plus Shura is really powerful. So, I mean, I really think Blackwings are going to make a nice splash back in the game. So that's nice to see. A lot of people were upset about the ban list. I wasn't upset. I was just more, like, in shock. I was ranting last night, but I think everybody was. I was just kind of doing it for fun. But I think there was some really healthy things. They basically, what that ban list did was put a restart button on the game, which was much, much needed. You know, I'm fairly happy about it. I'm a little, there's some weird stuff on that list. Like, they pretty much shut down all the cards that stop player interaction, but I'm really intrigued to see how things are going to roll. It's definitely going to be interesting, to say the least. Okay. Show kids. I just gotta fix on my decks because I have them all set up for the OCG ban list, which we all know is not actually our ban list. So let me just fix this here. I'm not running Gores anymore. I really don't like Gores. I was testing just one even last night and I thought it was pretty bad, to be honest. So I gotta remember what I was. So no more Storm, no more Reborn, no more Judgment. One Compulsory, and I ended up dropping the pinpoint guards. I like them, but Call is definitely better now that the game's slowing down. And I mean, the only thing I don't like is, to be honest, I feel like Call doesn't stop you from being OTK'd. But I mean, really, the only deck I think it's still super fast, and there's a couple of them, but is Insectors, Water, Heratix, and Medulche is going to be pretty fast. Yes, Adventure Philosophy, you can. Oops. So I really got to remember all the changes I did here. Oh, yeah. One card I'm really liking and testing is I think there's a few cards that people might be playing more of. And I think those cards are... I think those cards are going to be like Upstart Goblin. I've been testing is really, really good. And I was a little surprised by it. Honestly, I was like, whoa, this card's actually not bad anymore. Because, I mean, like, deck thinning's key. Like, we don't have as many big cards to get to, but you still, like, the game's a lot more just, like, deck-oriented now rather than, like, running a bunch of staples. So this is my lineup now, what I've been running, and it's actually testing really good. I was opting to run a third Duality over Upstart, because, I mean, Duality gets you your combo pieces, gets you to card, gets you to threatening more faster. But I felt like three Duality is really slow, especially after I open up my combo pieces. It's kind of slow. Yeah, sorry if the live stream is lagging, guys. We've been having internet issues for the past month. We're switching over to a new provider soon. But yeah, I mean, this card right here, Maxi, is probably going to lose a little bit of popularity. I still like it. I still think it's quite good. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 10, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. If I find I don't like the Maxis, sorry, I have a bad knee at the moment. I probably would take them out for the side deck and just run a Gores, because Gores can conflict a little bit with Call, but he's usually good. And another Mystic Tomato. As you guys know, I was running the Summoner Monk build. I might go back to it, but I'm kind of at the moment just playing it safe with Tomato, because I just felt Tomato's cool, because you can, like, crash, go... If you have the Hornet already in the grave or hand, you go Tomato, crash, grab Ladybug, and then you pop something, you Insect Imitation, grab Dragonfly, pop something else, Special Centipede, pop something else, overlay, and you're just, like, in a really good position. So I really, really like that. Honestly, a little more so than... the other stuff. So, and then I believe Shockmaster, like it says, ban. Which is strange. I really don't know what I'm going to replace him with, to be honest. Probably just run another four. Maestroke wouldn't be terrible. I could also run another... I'm just going to run another five. Adris is... Now, you know what? Really good is Zenmayo. This card's going to be so good now. Like, super good, because I mean, popping back rows now is good, because you think about it, all the cards that stop, these are the only cards that really stop summons. It's one compulsory, one bondless, one torrential, one warning, and Book of Moon, which I'm not running, but I don't really feel it's completely necessary in here. I could drop these for Book as well. If I had another card, probably run three cards and just worry about the Insector Engine. But okay, so that is that. And then I'm just going to fix Constellars up as well. Yep, Triple Phoenix Chain, only one bottomless, no Judgment, no Reborn, and no Storm. And I was testing Max Seas over Veiler, but I'll keep seeing how that rolls. Okay, so, let's see here, 1, 2, 3, 4. So, one compulse, one sec, sorry guys. Probably should have done this before the video, but it's not really a big deal, bottomless, compulsory... Oh yeah, two Mirror Force. Weird that they put Deep Prison to two still. I think that was kind of strange. But Konami does strange things, my friends. Strange things. If anyone's confused by why they hit stuff, it's because they basically or hit the back row cards. It's because they're like, okay, well, what are we going to do? If we ban Heavy Storm, people are just going to run a ton of, like, everyone's just going to run triple Compulse, two Bottomless, triple Deep Prison, you know, two Torrential. So, like, okay, what are we going to do? Like, let's put all those cards that wreck summons down to one, which makes a lot of sense. That means that people need to run cards that respond to effects or, you know, things like that instead, which I personally think makes a lot of sense. So I think that was a really, really good call on Konami's part. Yeah, when I get a bear, I'm probably just going to run two Sheratons, but I don't have bear right now because I'm waiting for the tin to come out. So until then, Duality. I do actually really like Duality in this deck. I think it's good, and I mean, now that the game's slowing down, I would never run three. I think three would be terrible, but... and what's the other one I'm going to run? I'm going to run... let's just run another Lance, I guess. Unfortunately, I would run three Lance if I had them, but Lance is going to go up in price again, guys. I should have gotten while they're cheap. Game's cray cray. Oh yeah, I can't run Shocky Locky anymore. So let's see here. What else am I missing in the extra deck? Stanky runs in Mayo here too, but I really don't think he's completely necessary. What could I run? My stroke I've already got. I could run Utopia. I don't like Utopia though. You know what? Let's just, because, you know, once in a blue moon it can happen. I'm just going to run Zen Mains. This card's going to be so good again now, because what are you going to do to Zen Mains? Compulse it? You got one, bro. Okay, so I'm going to test out Inzectors first, because they're my babies. And, oh yeah, I guess because a bunch of stuff got hit. I'm sure I think it's okay. Well, I'm gonna play an unlimited, so anybody who's playing stuff that's back to three can still play. So we're gonna go live on YouTube testing November 2013. Surprised it actually fits. Copy paste. Go. Okay. So anybody wants to join? I think I was gonna play that guy. Rooms up. Okay, so there he is there, and we're gonna play. So it's going to be a dice roll, as you guys all know, I always do dice roll. I think he's going to pick, yeah. Yeah, I think another reason why you have to run the triple call now is because there's going to be more stuff to respond to summons. That's a really good end, so we're going to roll. Rolls a two. I don't know if he's paying attention. Oh, yeah, apparently not. We'll just play. Oh, no, wait a minute. There he goes. Oh, rolls the one. So we are going to go to Spell Trap. We're going to make him level five. And I usually don't grab the Hornet first. I usually grab the Dragonfly first, but the reason I'm going to grab the Hornet first is because in this situation I did open with Sword, which is good. It's so bizarre now, I don't have to worry about getting stormed, I don't have to worry about, there's just so many things, it's so bizarre. Okay, and we're going to activate Upstart Goblin, because I like deck thinning. Draws the Dragonfly! No, ugh, of course, I draw that. That's awful. I'm just going to end. With this in hand, too, this is technically, as I think to call it, it's basically a dragonfly. Oh, Infernities. I'm going to be seeing that a lot, too. A bottomless. I did not want him dumping his whole hand, doing all his crazy plays. He's afraid to set anything. Yeah, he's not going to do anything here. So we are going to go summon Armageddonite. Effect. Kind of wish I grabbed the Dragonfly here, but what can you do? And I guess I could just honestly send... Just dump. Just dumping a ladybug. Okay, so we're gonna go spell trap. Level 5. I know I could have attacked first, but it's okay. Oh, sorry. Oops. Sorry. Multitasking. X24. Let's see if the XYZ is here. Okay, we're going to set one and end. This is so bizarre now. Oh, man. Yo. I think a lot more people are going to be running traps and stuff as well, which is a little scary. That's why I was thinking Foolish Burial is going to be... Not Foolish Burial. Trapstone's going to be very, very good. So he does dump the Stygian. He's probably going to set a shite ton of cards. There's another Stygian, okay. Okay. Oh, he's going to special the Archfiend. This game is so much slower now, it's insane. I'm going to let that through. He's going to overlay, and I'm going to Tory, because I don't want him to get through his play. But I want him to lose his Lavala chain, so. Add that back. Zack. Well, I think I lose. Good thing about the game is it's only going to be 4 months of the best decks. And then Konami's going to hit those things too, so. Probably should have saved the Torrential. I was just worried he had, like, I'm probably pooched. So I usually don't like Torrential and Zectors. Just set the barrier, and he's going to end. Okay, so we're going to summon Centipede. It's probably going to get banished. Has to, so scent effect. Wow. Yeah, he's sad. He sat pretty hard. probably pooched. So you guys can see the game is just so much slower. Hopefully I can get the dark hole here. That would be really good. Oh, that's really good too, actually. I don't know why I'm lagging really bad. Sorry, guys, one sec. That's why I don't like three duality, because when you duality, it's terrible. I don't like the upstart. Well, we'll just hope this goes through. I drew an awkward hand. Like, it was a good hand, but it was like he opened really good, fortunately. Fernandes really didn't lose a whole lot. Probably got another freaking barrier down. Doesn't have anything. Oh yeah. Well, let's equip the sword. I don't want to hit the Archfiend. Let's pop that. That's why I did that. So we're going to go normal summon. Pretty much just picking off those back rows so I can make my play. Sure, so you know I have game. Because I was just going to pop, and then special dragonfly, pop, pop, run it over, and then he's in like a top decking situation. That's pretty good. I think these are going to test really well, because these are essentially like, you know, you're running 37 cards instead, which I personally like, because I want to get to my like Dark Arm Dragon, I want to get to Hornet and stuff like that. Of course, I don't have Max C. Fernies is probably going to be one of the best decks in the game, honestly. I'd be very surprised if it wasn't. A lot of people complain about good hands. Oh, my hand sucked because you had bottomless. Okay. Yeah, here we go. That card should be hit. It's a stupid card. Because now I can't Dark Hole him, because if I Dark Hole him, he gets two Archfiends and he gets a Surge, and then he starts going off, and yada, yada, yada. I guess he's just going to do it now. And two Archfiends is one misses timing if he specials them both off of them. Launcher, which is good. I don't even pay attention now, to be honest. Yeah, why did they ban Stratos and Gateway, not Launcher? Kind of weird. Well, there's the card D. That's good. Oh, I don't want to die. Fudge Nugget. Dark Hole. Yeah, obviously. Herp Derp. Probably got Break, too. Yeah, I think I'm scuppered. Hope when he summons, no. So dumb. I did that too early again, but it really doesn't matter. He's gonna go off anyways. Yeah. Gives me a little advantage back at least. I still really think Venus Chain's gonna be like MVP card of the format. People just don't realize it yet. Like, yeah, everyone's gonna be riding triple Lance and stuff, but Venus Chain's still really good. Excuse me, I'm fudged. I'll take 18. Oh, please draw. No. Those freaking Archfiends. I don't think I can get over that thing, because I don't have anything to equip. This game. He's just going to keep gaining advantage. Playing against a friend isn't fun, then why are you playing it? Don't get some people's logic. Oh, that's not bad. That's pretty good. I'm not complaining. Stack number 16. I'll take it. Now, if I draw a Hornet, I have game. See, I don't know if I want to. I got the call, so should be okay. Oh, one sec, guys. Somebody's at the door. Apparently, a Jehovah's Witness again.
Oh, good day, sir. The lottery. The dad was here today, I was.
Yeah.
They never let me, they never asked me to do anything, or I left a message before they left.
I have a plant upstairs, I don't need water.
Okay. But it looks like you're supposed to say water when you're here. So.
They didn't see them there, but they aren't here for very long, they're only here for about 20 minutes or so.
Sorry.
Sorry. Okay. He's probably got something, but we'll see what happens here. I don't really want to waste the dragonfly right away. I think I will, though. That's fact. And this is where you go pro plays and you grab the Hornet. And then he activates chain disappearance. That would suck. I could have done Dweller there, but I'm going to go Tyrus because I'm still worried he has, like, a Bottomless or something. As you guys know, I do have Call of the Haunted set, so that puts me in a really good position. I mean, he hasn't responded yet. I kind of... This guy would be really good. But we're going to go Tyrus because I want to pop some stuff. The one warning! Do it! Do it! Not doing it! No, he's got nothing. Oh, baby. All the plays. Oh, it's the barrier. So good. So good. And just because, you know, keeping that in your hand now is bad. For some strange reason. We're going to detach that. And one turn. This deck is still really good. Still very consistent. Oh, he's doing his plays. Archfiend, Yu-Gi-Oh! Okay. Probably should have done Dweller. I do know Infernity's probably run Mirror Force, though, so that was kind of my logic behind it. This card's going to be good next format. Anything that has to be destroyed is going to be amazing, because like Bombless at 1, Tori at 1, you know, those obviously don't really hurt the other cards, but okay, he's going to grab the break. So he's going to set it, which is cool with me. Oh, what's he going to hit? I'm going to start picking off my back rows here. Okay. Please hit the one I just set. Yeah, boy. Yeah, boy. I like how setting MST now is actually good. That doesn't make any sense. Oh man, Yu-Gi-Oh's just ruined itself. I like life points. Oh, look, another one! Oh my gosh, watch this, draw the third one! Oh, that's really good. Triple call is so stupid now, like, what the frick? Huzzah! Nothing. It's probably got Call of Haunted set, though, which is kind of scary. So he takes 800. Pop that one. Oh, it's another barrier. That's a sad panda day right there. And I mean, the next turn I just win because I got two calls set. So I'm just going to end phase, detach. In turn. He's probably got Called Haunted. I'd be very surprised if he doesn't. It's Armageddon Knight. Okay. That's cool. Thompson Archfiend. It's interesting. Oh, he's got the launcher. Okay. That means he's going to bring out two, though, so that's fine. Or he's just going to do one? Both. Okay. One effect. So he's only got one barrier left, one thing. He's already normal summoned, so I'm going to torrential on that. Okay, so we go live on YouTube. Like I said, Pinpoint Guard is really, really good, though. I'm really liking it. I'm liking the upstarts. They're good. They're drawing me in the stuff I need. And, you know, I'm always very content with that. This is looking kind of familiar. And he's going to go scissors again. No, rock. And I'm going to go scissors. Oh, you got me. It's okay. We're going to go dice roll. Finally draw dad. Rolls to four. Rolls the two. I hate when people shuffle when they do that. It drives me nuts. So we're going to draw. Ladybug. Oh, poop. Okay, I'm going to go set two because these are both really good. When water wastes cards, trying to pop it. Setting call versus water is bad. Yeah, here we go. Comes the dirt. Oh, yeah, here we go. It started. hit the T-Roar. No attacking me this turn. Buddy. Hey, buddy. Canadian buddy. Buddy, buddy, buddy. So he gets a search and doesn't go minus because water is broken. This card poops on it, though. So glad they didn't ban this. If they banned this card, I probably would have quit. Honestly, I would have. Because this is, like, such an important card. I'm tempted to even run this from friggin' Samurai now. So he's going to summon... Nope. Set. Okay, cool. Oop, discard card D. Back. Draw. Enter. And he's activated Sphere, probably. Nope. Sphere should have been put to one. It really should have. Summons Lind. Kind of on the bottomless that, to be honest. But I can probably just take it. Yeah, I'll take it. Sets one. Oh, please draw Ladybug. If I draw Ladybug, it's like GG's. This is a really awkward play, but I'm just going to set this and because I'm worried he has an MS or I probably should have set that too, to be honest. I hate setting MST versus water so bad though. Attacks for 15 again. Oh my gosh, okay. It's gonna have to go for it. I really hate doing this, but we'll see what happens. It's either gonna be really good or really bad. Seeing a response. Try to activate that. It's a cost. Good. I think if he had the warning, he probably would have used it already on the call. He doesn't have anything. So, in this situation here, I'm just going to go for the dragonfly play. Water doesn't really run a lot of back rows, so. See, I could actually go. I'm actually slightly worried about Torrential, to be honest. I really am. But if he Tories me, I'm pretty sure I can OTK him. Possibly. I kind of want to go. Dweller would be really good, but I mean he's just gonna Tory the Dweller anyways, so we'll just go 5. It's probably the best play. And because Yu-Gi-Oh and I have another imitate. And we're going to overlay. Kind of want to do that, but he's probably got Sphere, which I don't like. Trying to think what the smartest play is here. I feel like I don't need this guy in the extra deck, to be honest. I would rather just run Aedris, if anything. This card is really good against water. I'm going to have to do it. I kind of wanted to detach the Tyrus, the dude this turn, but we'll see what happens. So I'm just going to attack. Get that guy off the board. And then end phase. Pop that. It's probably a sphere. Oh, I got the call. Good hit, Graham. Good hit. Okay, and then main phase two. We're going to set that. And if he does kill this, I got mega plays. So that's really good. I'm going to detach the Hornet. Really surprised they didn't put call down to one. I thought they were going to. So he summons Pike. Okay. Dumps Gund. Gund. A special back the Deus, which is cool. He gets another search, which is fine. He's probably going to grab another marksman. That would make the most sense. Fishborg Archer, okay. A special Megalo. does this have to pop? This build is testing really well, though. I like it. The upstarts are great. Deck thinning is key. Not a very good hand. I like that. This probably should have never gone past two, actually. This card won me that regionals I just about topped, but I had to leave early. This card won me so many games that day. It was just so insane. Yeah, Prophecy is definitely going to be a great deck in this next format. Oh, this is an awesome hand. Okay, so we're going to go set, Gardevoir, all the plays. Perfect. Please don't draw Hornet. Okay, that's fine. Sometimes, I mean, Trishula's not in the game and stuff, but usually like to wait until I actually have a play before I play this, because I don't know if I'm going to need a Ladybug, or I don't know if I'm going to need a Hornet. Sometimes Ladybug's better than Hornet. You don't want to like dump one and then wish you dump the other, so. Stoik. Stoik! Wish Psychics were faster. I'd totally play them. Jeff Jones style. They got wrecked by water, though, unfortunately. So he flips up the Lind, which is totally fine. And he's going to
Special TS. So give me an extra draw. Still is a normal summon, which is fine. Lin goes off, which gives me another card. Lead, cool. Dragonfly. Ugh, that's bad. Summons Gund. T-Roar. Yeah, sure. I can hit the Dark Arm Dragon. I called it. Okay, Dad wasn't doing anything. Kind of dead. Ooh, I like that. Well, boys and gals, should I just go for it? I should just go for it. See if he has anything. I don't think he does. Yu-Gi-Oh! That was the next card, too. Too funny. Foolish. That's why you save it, boys and girls. I kind of want to cut something around another tomato, though. I really like tomato. I like it better than Monk, honestly. Monk, like, the Monk build is so bad, because if you got, like, Fiendish Chained Veiler, they max to you, you're just, like, scooping it up, boys. Effect. I guess Guy off the board first here. He might have Bottomless, though. I'm gonna hit that. Hopefully not a Sphere. Yeah, I'm an MST. It's a good idea running call. It's actually a very good idea. You watch this, you got the freaking Bottomless. Which I actually be okay with. Flash lag. Bad internet. Oh. Probably another one. Yeah, Sphere. Watch this. Watch this. Boom. And just because Yu-Gi-Oh's, Set. It's gonna end. Not gonna XYZ because not too worried, honestly. Summon. Okay. Marksman. Gund. Skirt right here, boys. Still really good. Yeah, so he's gonna grab the marksman. He's probably gonna use his fishborg things effect. So dumb how much water can plus, it's just crazy. He's gonna do an XYZ play here. Back to title. Oh, sure. Oh, you mean the dump? Dump's another title. Assume he's gonna, if he makes big eye, it doesn't really matter because I'm just gonna either pop whatever he grabs and then just go off. So what was it? I read this thing. This guy's in your graveyard and you control no monsters during either of your main phases. Oh yeah, I have to have no monsters. Sure he's gonna make here. Oh yeah, Master Blades, sure. We're gonna TRR. Did you draw a ladybug? Unfortunately, I can't pop that bugger. Vulcasaurus targets, doesn't he? Target, yeah. This guy target? Yeah. Okay, if anybody else wants to play, I'm testing out the new format, so anyone wants to give it a whirl. Yeah, actually, Wade, if you're still watching, I totally agree with you. I don't think heroes are dead. People are like, oh, Stars is gone, my heroes are dead. I don't think they're dead, they're just like a lot slower, because Stratos was just like this completely broken spammy card that you can like do whatever you want, but you don't really have that option anymore, so. Excuse me. Sure, let's play Loser Shane. Oh, wait a minute, am I playing? Oh, frick, sorry, I forgot to change it to, sorry. Forgot to put it down limited. Then we'll run into some douchebag playing dragons. You want to play Anonymous? Let's play. You've been watching for a while. So we are going to dice roll, though. I always pick rock. Nice, that's a good end. Okay, so I mean, I could start things off just by setting that, but I think the best play is just to kind of get the card car off. So effect. Nice, that's pretty good. Yeah, these games, you guys notice, are so much slower. Like, it's... Are you guys watching this right now? Dude. This guy's playing the wrong new format. Okay, anybody else who knows what's going on? That was really funny. Oh, man. He's so good, he can run banned cards. Oh, too funny. Too funny. Oh, wait, I forgot to put it on limited again. That was hilarious. Actually, you know, I'm going to play some Stellars. Oh man, that was too funny. Too funny. I really don't know what my fourth deck is going to be. I'm going to be playing Sam's because they still have triple double edge. They have Musakani and all that great stuff, but I really don't know what I'm going to play. This is pretty good. I'm not complaining. I'm just going to normal summon. Fact. Make him 5. We'll set to land. Interested to see what deck I'll be playing here. Sets a back row. Sets a second back row. So that's another back row. Someone's card card DD. Okay. It doesn't bother me too much. You know what I was thinking I'm like sort of running instead of bear actually in this deck? Is this is definitely gonna be more of a back row format. I was thinking gorilla is actually gonna be a lot better. Just be able to pop back rows and then kind of go off. Oh, there we go. Grab that dude. This is actually really good because I get a Sombre play. So, let's go Pollux. Cost. Interesting. Let's just play the tanky. Got the mystical. Okay. Cool with me. Stack 17. And what was the end? God, Drupa. Good. This card is going to be good again, I think. Bad mill. Bad mill. Oh, man, all the bad mills. So good. Kills the costs. That's weird. Okay, sure. Interesting. Means he probably has torrential. But yellow. Deep prison. If I want to let that go through. Yeah, that's fine. That's gone, by the way. Almost in. How did he gain advantage over me? Oh, right, he ran. No, that still wouldn't have been advantage. I'm really confused. Hold up, Maxi. Oh, these mills are great. Oh, he's played in Zectors. Ew, this is such a bad build. Someone's card car. Can't. This guy, I don't really think he knows what he's doing. The centipede. Gigamantis. Okay. Sure. So that is 1924. Tier 7 is 700. How could I be there if I was a better man? That's a good top deck. Let's see, that's not mystical. Start on this highway. Sombre is a broken card, broken card, broken card. Sombre is a broken card, la da dee doo dee dee. Punish the costs. And back the bullocks. No, what's that? Course effect. Oh, he still got the freaking warning. He still got it. He got it? Does he got it? Pleiades doesn't really do anything in this situation. This card poops on Zectors. Warning! Do it! Well, that's a Mirror Force set. No cards. Yeah, this guy's build's not very good, to be honest. Takes 1150. Chain's call, sure. And we're gonna set one in phase detach. And one. I think he's pooched. Still used here. Yeah, he's low on stuff. Still hasn't drawn anything. The troopers are working out well because he's drawing the calls. Like, that's good, but I feel like troopers too slow, and then you mill all your good cards, and I mean, avarice isn't around anymore, so like, it's, I don't know, I just feel like it's wasted space. Random blind MST. Sure. Kind of a waste. Duality. Yeah, this guy's not a very good Inzektor player, unfortunately. Oh, there's the Hornet. How could I be there if I was a better man? So he just wasted his MST, and he could have hit the Fiendish Chain, which I'm about to hit his guy with. This place for days, boys. This place for days. Okay. Yeah, you have to equip it as a cost, bro. Obviously doesn't play Inzektors. Kind of wish I'd made something else here, honestly. Oh, there's another chain. Battle phase, I have to pop. End phase. Oh, yeah, that's gone too. Yeah, I probably should have just made the Pleiades. That would have been a smarter play. You just protect Sombra and you just plus off of them. The back row. Someone's card D. Okay. I'm gonna Fiendish Chain card D. I'm good at this game. Yo. Oh my gosh, so good. Act. Yeah, game's slowing down a lot, so obviously Tomato is a lot better. I don't get his logic, though. I see he runs Monk, but he's only running, like,
What, I've seen seven spells. How would I suppose if I was a better man? Okay, let's go play somebody else with Constellers, because they're really good. Oblivion, I know you're watching this, you turkey, come play me. Lost up on this highway. I suppose if I was rock is winning all day long. Rock is winning in that in this song. No, I lost that one. Yu-Gi-Oh! Yeah, baby, Yu-Gi-Oh! Oh my gosh, this is hilarious. That. I'm gonna grab Bear. Bert, I'm gonna grab Bert. Constellar Fire, Constellar Bear. Fire Fist Bert. All the Burrs. I like set five backrow formats. All the cards are really good. Hoopla, hoopla. Scrubbios are really good. Hoopa scoopa lay. I believe I can fly. And I believe I can touch the sky. I think about it every night and day. Spread my wings and fly away. I believe I can soar. See me running through that open door. I believe I can fly. Anybody who has a rabbit picture is a scrub. Oh, I'm so glad that gay little bunny's at one. I freaking hate rabbit. It's such a gay card. I hate summons that activates the turnkey. I'm probably playing four axis fire fags. This is that rare occasion, right? I don't know why I'm running Maxi, to be honest. I kind of wish I was running Valor. Valor's going to be really good this format. Maxi, I don't think, is going to be as good because it's just so slow. The format, not the card. Maxi's good. I like Maxi, but I think it's going to be more of a side deck card. In my real build, I run. Oh, what the frick? Okay. Interesting. Summon Tengu Crash. Okay. Hold up. Oh, I wonder if this guy would be upset with me if I activated Vanity's Emptiness. Rage quit? Kind of neat idea though, TG Striker. I really like how this card's back at 2. I don't know why the frick that thing went to 1. No one's ever gonna run the 3 though. I don't know why I just didn't go back to 3, to be honest. I just got nothing. Oh, too funny. Let's just summon that Tengu. Sure. Wait a minute. Okay. Let's go set.
Normal summon. Bottomless too. Bottomless is, I'd be fine with that because you can't do anything. We'll just end. Oh, Vanity's emptiness is gonna be so good, this format. So good. I'm hoping more people play GBs, because if they do, it's gonna be really, really funny. I'm just thinking here, so he's in there. Thinking here. Lance, he goes down. So he goes up to 2,000. I'm gonna hate seeing TGs again. I hate that deck. This is why I wish these were MSTs. I like MST better than Lance, to be honest. I do that, I lose my vanities thing. I'm gonna draw cards. I'm gonna have a warning that. Fortunately. He had to go minus off that compulse, so. Ooh, baby, Dark Bribe. Okay, sure. Still attacking. Okay, so he's still gonna attack. What? That sucks for him. Okay, go. That was the right play. Lance. Boom. So he goes on a 17. Crash. Oops. To attack. Lands. Play duality. Oh, that Rota looks pretty good. Oh, so is that. Let's go the Rota. Grab that nice little Pollux. Summon that. I don't know if I like the one bear though with too tanky. I mean, I guess it's okay. It's okay. It's like it's not great. And we'll grab another. I personally though, I actually like two tanky better than I like three. Because I found like with only four targets and three tankies, it was a bit kind of like overkill sometimes. And we'll end. I'm in a really winning position right now. I don't know if he's going to come out of this, to be honest. Oh, rips the dark hole. Well, I really don't need bear anymore, so I'm going to... You know what? I'm going to let that through. It's okay. It's Barbaros. Yeah, sure. That's cool. Rather not waste the lance. Oh man, if that's a freaking drain, I'm gonna be so chapped. Alex, so good. Oops. Still in a good spot here. So if he had deep prison, I could have just gone lance on my guy, lance on his guy, and wouldn't have changed anything. So we're going to go... Might as well... Back then for days. Oh. Sorry. Doesn't want me to grab that cost. Watch this draw Sombre. No. I don't really need Compulse, so I'm just going to set the chain. That's a monster. YOLO. It's probably a TG monster. Whatever he grabs doesn't really matter. Should bounce his tanky for him. that'd be the considerate thing to do. So this is why I like running three of this little searcher guy, because he grabs you Sombre fast. Like, Sombre is like the busted card in the deck. Sets Striker, sets something. Pollux, not doing anything for me. Let me get that out of the back row there. The end phase? During the end phase? Yeah, right, okay. I heard that's a good card, so we'll set that. The reason I got bounced back is I didn't want that stuck in the back row. Depending on what he does next turn, I'll make my push. That might be a Horn of the Phantom Beast, actually. That would be pretty funny. So the thing about TGs is it's a really good slow deck. Okay. You watch, it's a freaking Horn of the Phantom Beast. Yeah, it's Horn of the Phantom Beast. Okay. Lol! that's too good. Oh, MST would have done the exact same thing. You just MST before the damage stat. So we take 700. That was funny. There's my little Sheraton bugger. And we are going to grab Kos. We're going to summon Sheraton. Perfect. Like this guy, he's so good. So good. Grab the sombre. So you guys can see this deck is going to be really freaking retarded. The only reason I like the lances, like they've been good, but I think I don't know if you guys noticed, but every single time I had a lance, if it was an MST, it would have done the exact same thing technically. I would have had to just use it. Like at the first turn, we had those two back rows. These would have been two MST set. I would have just end phase popped as two MSTs, and I would have been fine. So. Takes 34, and I kind of like leaving the zone open. I got so much stuff here, though. I'm fine, so I'm just going to hang. Probably in a GG position here, to be honest. Yeah, this is looking good for him. Wow. Yu-Gi-Oh. Torrential, which is cool, because that means I got a game. He also used it too early as well. How could I be there if it was a better man? All the rage quits. Balm! Fun with that back row. So that one time was good. But he used the Torrential too early. You're supposed to wait for the Algaide. Although I'd safe zone anyway, so I would have probably just been like safe zone Sombre. GG! Although he would have chained Bulk, which would have sucked. Okay. We'll play one more. I gotta go make some food or something in a bit here. Constellars, people, you're gonna be seeing them a lot. A lot of Constellars. A lot. I'm running two Mirror Force in my build, but I was actually thinking of running two Pinpoint Guards in the deck. I thought Pinpoint Guard was gonna be really good in this deck. Just because, I mean, you can bring back Sombre, you know, but I don't think it's... There's no floater in the deck. I mean, the other thing that's cool is you can obviously bring back Honest, too. And when you bring back Honest, you could technically, you know, it can't be destroyed the next turn, you just bounce it back to your hand, which is good as well. But I just felt it wasn't really necessary. M7 technically does the practically the same thing. This guy likes paper. A rock, I mean. Don't tell anybody, guys. I just went and did paper. Betrayed everyone. I think Constellars actually has a really good water matchup, too, to be honest, because like they just kind of kill everything. Oh, this hand's amazing. OMG, I just cream my drawers. Cream my drawers, boys! This card's good right here. Anybody who says Algaide is bad or only runs two, you need to reconsider why you play Constellars, because Algaide is incredible. In this situation, I'm going to save the Algaide because I don't need it. I'm just going to go with Pollux. Goss. Perfect. You could technically go
Pollux, Elgati, if they Valor it, or Max C, then you're fine. And then if they cost the second effect, you're still in a good position. But opening this hand's really, really good, because you know, this is where I can obviously abuse the brokenness known as Pleiades. Send him to the grave. And you just go set. And during, I got this too, so GG. Oh man, too good. Too good. Let's see what deck we're playing here. Tori, okay. Watts? I'm thinking it's Watts. If it was Watts, that's not. Watts would actually be a really good deck this format. Because they're kind of a slower stun deck, too. I never even thought of Watts, actually. That's actually a really good call. I'm definitely, definitely very excited for YCS Toronto at the end of the month. Sure. Might as well just bounce it back to hand. Like plus ones. Yeah, YCS Toronto. Oh, wind ups. That makes sense. That makes sense. Unfortunately, I don't think. Ooh, that's really good versus wind ups. I don't really think that's going to be very good this format. So tanky. Did he grab Torrential? I forget if he did. To be honest, I don't remember. We're gonna go for M7. Can't use his effect this turn, but that's okay. I'm just gonna set one. And I'm not gonna use the effect because I forget if he had the Torrential. I wasn't paying attention. That's called me zoning out, not caring, because it's Dueling Network. And most people who play Messenger of Peace usually forget to pay the 100, so just remind them. How could I suppose if Thunder King does a whole lot against this deck? Oh, yeah. Okay. Oh, my gosh, that's so good. Man, I could do so much here. I kind of want to sit on the M7 because he can't really add either. I'm going to do this. I'm just going to set. I have so much setup. If he tries to go off, I win. So. Let's forget. This is where I wish I was running MSTs instead of stupid Lance. Well, I could just bounce back the Thunder King, special Adris, and Lance it. Oh, this is only monsters, isn't it? Yeah, it's only monsters. Poop. So I wish I still played these. He's just gonna negate it. I'm send. It's like wind up stun or something. Keeps forgetting. Pay, buddy. Everybody who plays Messenger of Peace always forgets to pay 100. Oh, he's running Chain Beat? Really?
That deck's actually going to be really good this next format. I don't like that. This isn't special summon either. Balls. Well, I'm kind of just going to go for it, I guess. Grab or cost back, I guess. Is there anything else I could use that could blow crap up? He doesn't do anything. All Kasalamatsu currently control are unaffected by spell or trap effects this turn. That means I could attack. They are level 5. Okay, scrub. Apparently doesn't know how to read. Pro plays. If I got a deep resin or something, that's okay. Doesn't have it. Ooh, baby. And darn. Owned? That was special. Is it during your next time of phase from this card? No, it's not. Okay. That dark hole is looking pretty good. Yeah. Just go with me. Perhaps a bear. Guy's in such a rush. I heard that's a card. Terrace is looking pretty good. He hasn't chained the Thunderbird yet, so. Ooh, got the D prison. That's psyche. Okay, sure. Let's roll again. Yeah. I'm gonna admit, that guy's a douche. Like how compulsory is like a sack card now, like Mirror Force, you only got two of them. It's funny. So I'll play one more. I got time. Sure, let's play this dude. Going first this time. Oh man, I gotta like organize a binder now just for ban cards. There's so many of them I have, it's insane. Put them in my Vanguard stuff, I guess. I got some ban cards in here actually. Snatch Steel. Just sets one. I'm taking this card out. It's bad now. The game's so much slower. Of course, he has a Rico. Yeah, might as well chain it. See, if that was a Veiler, it would have been better. Maxi's really only good against water now, personally. Not the best mills there for him. I might lose this one because I don't have a good matchup versus Lightsworn. Yeah, I'll take 1900. Oh, Stinky, which I can't use. It's a Thunder Faggot. Ugh, I hate doing this, but I have to. The one Thunder King. That's too funny. Which is surprisingly hard to get over now, which is kind of funny, actually, when I think about it. Oh no! Grab the other 10 key. So good. And now Bear's like, I'm useless! Okay, well then. Well, they gave me a little bit of advantage back, but not much. This card is just god awful. I don't know why I'm running it. MST? Okay. Sure. Yay! XC's actually going to do something. I like drawing cards. Hey, I like drawing cards. Hey. Yay! Pluses! Oh, he's got that BLS. Oh, he does. Oh, he's going for it. He's going big. Oh, he's gonna hate me. Oh, yeah, because Mirror Force is a card. Sorry, bro. Oh man, sad panda days. Bear beat down. How's the Algaidia spellcaster? You know what I just thought? Is that Pot of Duplicity is actually gonna be really good in here too, because they're all random, like Beast Warrior, Spellcaster, Fairy, Beast. Like, what is that, five different types? One, two, three, four. Yeah. One, two, three, four, five. Yeah, five different types. So, I mean, Pot of Duplicity could actually be decent in here. Let's see if he's grabbing here. What do you mill? Oh, he's playing Sea Dragons. It's Chaos Dragon. That makes more sense. With Light Sword. Splash, dude. I really hope he summons Lumina and discards. Do it. Do it. Do it. I'm going to Vanity's Emptiness. Do it. Oh, what a June Nugget. Do it. Do it. Do it. Yeah. Okay. Whoa! too funny. All the salt. Miller Wolf! Miller Wolf! That'd be so funny. Well, I might as well just summon Algaidi, I guess. Honest. Oh, if you honest, that would have been sick. I think he loses. I don't think he can play around this. I think he's scuppered. Sets one. I'm kind of thinking that is a Raikou. I'm just going to end. Probably is. Or it's a bluff. Give me a bluff. I think it's a bluff. Or he's just waiting. Okay, fuck it, I'm going in. Oh, but if that's something, all he has to do is pop something else, and then the vanity's emptiness dies too, which I really don't like. Really don't like that. Let's go some Pollux. Let me go attack. That's probably Ryko. Arcus. Wow. Did not expect that. Okay, that's cool. Still can't do anything. That Arcus and his big ass. Tribute summon. This should be a crashing situation. Lose two cards. Going to crash here. Just still fine because I'm in a winning position. Then I can just go Sombre OTKs for days. You didn't mill Gores though, which is a little scary. I'm drawing weird. Never mind. Another target. Oh, my knee. What would be the best situation here? I could go. Well, if I go main phase two Peladon. Well, this is game. Let's just try and push it through. He's probably got something. I'd be very surprised if he didn't. Yeah, I didn't think so. GG. Oh, man, on the control. Stellars are just so gross. I think Sea Dragon's actually pretty good this format, to be honest. Less bottomless and D Fisher and stuff. That one Ram Thunder King is really funny. Okay, guys, thanks for watching. I gotta organize my cards here. Constellars are testing fairly well. I did lose to that Chain Beat guy, but he kind of was drawing the outs there anyway. So, but yeah, thanks for watching. Comment down below. How do you guys feel about the new format? How do you think it's gonna roll? I think Constellars are gonna be really good. Inzektor's been testing well. I still think Water is just retarded, but that's because they have freaking what the hell's that guy's name? Tidal. I freaking hate the E-Dragons. I just think they're so dumb. I personally also think Samurais are going to be really good because there's like less stuff that really kills Sheehan. But I don't know. It's still a little sketchy. But anyways, yeah, we'll see what happens. Once again, make sure to like, comment, and subscribe. And I will have some deck profiles up for you guys soon. I might even throw up my, because I do have my Constellars finished. They're pretty much done. I am missing the bear, but like I said, you can just not run bear and you're okay. You can run, honestly, like a gorilla. I'm honestly thinking gorilla would almost be a little bit better than bear to hit those back rows so you can, make your safe plays. But
In all fairness, you could easily just run three of each Constellar and you're still in a really good spot. And I'm honestly not liking the Max Cs. I'd rather just run Valor. I think Valor is just a better card right now. And yeah, other than that, the deck's testing really well, and I'll have a deck profile up for you guys tonight. I like how my Inzectors are testing too, but I'm still trying to like figure them out. Some stuff I may change. Kind of tweak things a little bit, but we'll basically see what happens. Other than that, Samurai, I think I have my Samurai build pretty much down pat too. People are like, oh, Samurais are dead because Gateway got banned. No, dude, like most of my tournaments that I've topped with Samurai, I draw Gateway like maybe twice all day. Like you rarely see it, and when you do see it, it's like late game and it's so terrible and dead. So I think like Gateway should have been banned, although I honestly think Sheehan could have gone back to two, but I guess the reasoning was that if the game slowed down, multiple Sheehans is still really nasty. And I get that, I totally get that. But I think Samurais are gonna be really good this format, so one of those decks keeping an eye out for. So thanks for watching, guys. Peace.